Welcome back. You're still watching Insight. The Philippines saw the expansion of the gig economy during the COVID-19 pandemic. Many employees shifted to freelancing, considering the number of benefits it brings, like better pay and shorter working hours. Now, the rising number of freelancers in the country prompted calls for a measure protecting these workers. For more on this, we now have with us Aimee Morales, founder of Freelance Writers Guild of the Philippines. So let's begin with an overview of the current condition of freelancers in the Philippines. How are they doing considering that there is no law right now that solely focused on protecting the rights of freelancers?
There are some laws in place right now in the Philippines. For example, we have the copyright law, and also we have the Telecommuting Act. Recently, we have the Creative Industries Development Act. Now, aside from this, we also have the small claims courts, and in terms of structure, and also we have the individual contracts between the hiring party and the freelancer. So all of these things, they offer some form of protection for freelancers. However, it's also true that there are many aspects of our practice and our profession that still need to be studied because there are regulations and policies that are clearly lacking still. So to answer your question about the current state, many of us are still struggling along with other workers as well, even the regular employees and the government employees who are reeling from the effects of the pandemic and inflation. So we are going through all of these things on a regular basis. And aside from that, like I said earlier, there are still other aspects or other issues pertaining to our profession that still need to be studied by lawmakers and by government. So generally, that's the picture.
So what are some of the common concerns that you hear from freelancers? And you talked about some issues that are not yet being addressed by lawmakers. So if you had a wish list, what are these issues that you want regulators to address?
We actually have a long list, but I would probably mention around maybe three issues. One of them would be subsidy for our social protection. I mean, everybody knows that the private employees of private corporations and the government employees, the companies pay for their insurance, for their medical, dental, housing, health insurance. And even the government employees are also, their insurance is also subsidized partly by the government. So for freelancers, if we choose to enroll ourselves, for example, to sign up for SSS or for PhilHealth, we have to pay for the whole amount, for the full amount, because it's 100%. So that's one of the things that maybe the government can help us with, is maybe to subsidize a percentage, even a small part of this protection. Another issue would be the rates. We know it's difficult to set a minimum rate or a standard rate across all freelancing fields because but it's possible to include maybe in the legislation that the respective guilds or associations of in each freelance industry, for example, the actors or the writers, such as the Freelance Writers Guild of the Philippines, the visual artists, the dancers, etc., can recommend a pay range that can guide the hiring party and the freelancer when they are drafting their contracts. No, that's one thing, because some clients are really paying low, not just the local clients, but also international clients from overseas. The goal is for this to become the norm in the various industries so that we can gradually remove the mentality that the cheapest is the winner, because that's how it is currently when you're hiring, when you're choosing freelancers or consultants. Also, It will help to institutionalize also the guilds and the associations. For us in FWGP, it's very important to have a group. You know, your voice is louder and it's clearer when you're speaking as a community, as a group. So for us, we don't have an HR department. That will really serve to protect the community. The third thing that I would like to mention would be access to legal aid, because freelancers usually lack the budget for legal representation if they experience some injustice or abuse, or if they want to file complaints, they would usually just, you know, be forced into silence or inaction if they don't have the budget to hire a lawyer and go through the process. So it's our hope that the new laws can provide also an easier and clearer way for us freelancers to file complaints and to get legal assistance on work-related matters.
Are you still seeing more Filipinos shifting to freelancing even as more companies are now resuming their normal work setup?
I'm not sure if they are shifting, but in my community, there are still a lot of freelancers doing freelance work, even if they have a regular job. So they still do it on the side. And aside from that, there are people who still cannot go back to work, like mothers with young children. So they really have to resort to freelancing. So I think many of the younger workers also prefer to work from home and prefer to join the gig economy. So I think there's still a growing community, growing industry.
So those who need the flexibility or prefer the flexibility, they still choose freelancing.
Yes, ma'am.
How important is the economic contribution of freelancers?
Well, just like regular employees, we also pay taxes. From our pay, the clients deduct the withholding taxes. So aside from that, just like everyone else, we're also consumers. So we are in a way supporting industries and businesses. And some of us also get paid in dollars and other foreign currencies, because we are able to obtain international contracts. So I think in those ways, we are also contributing to nation building.
So what's your long-term outlook for the local gig economy? Is it still positive?
Kind of hard to say for sure, but if we are going to look at the regulations or the policies being implemented and being talked about in the Senate, in Congress, and it looks like it's slowly getting some kind of support that it did not used to get, especially if some of the pending legislation can be passed, like the Freelancers Workers Protection Act. And if you are also looking at the preferences of workers and how society is slowly embracing this non-traditional form of work, this traditional work arrangement, it seems like more people are also choosing to go freelance. And considering also the volatile situation of our security, peace and order, health, you know, environment, and so on, freelancing certainly seems like a very viable option if we're talking about livelihood. So I think it will still continue to grow, especially here in the Philippines and in Asia, in the years to come.
You're right. Like, more people right now are embracing it as a viable option. Yes. For, you know, alternative jobs, especially for, as you said, young mothers or individuals who want more flexibility. So with that, thank you very much for your thoughts, Aimee. And, you know, I look forward to those regulations that will help protect the rights of freelance workers.